Welcome. Today we are going to work on Dataflow quick start tablets. We can do it with this one or this one with Python. For training reasons, I'm going to make two videos, one for this one and one for this one. So let's click with the tablets. Okay, so Dataflow. In this lab, you will learn how to create a streaming pipeline using Google's Cloud Dataflow tablets. More specifically, you will use the Cloud PubSub to BigQuery tablet, which reads messages written in JSON from a PubSub topic and pushes them to BigQuery table. You can find the documentation for this tablet here. So there are two very useful links. Click on them, read the documentation, and then start the lab. Okay, please don't do it directly. Start the lab. Again, to remind you that when we start the lab, the time starts counting down and we cannot pause the time. Over here, we must get 100 points. If you click it, it will expand. And we are ready. So we'll start the lab. I'm not a robot. I will use subscription. I'm going to copy the student open console incognito and let me make my screen like this. Next, I need the password. I'm getting the password from over here. Okay, I need to use my student ID and the password that Qwik Labs provide for me. Next, accept. I will confirm that. And over here, yes, I have to agree. For email updates, this one is for your real projects on Google Cloud, not for the student. Okay, so agree and continue. Okay, this is my platform over here with the resources that the one credit that I have paid. This is my project ID over here. And as you can see, I'm on my student account and not my account or my company's account. Let's scroll down. We have done everything here. We are going to activate Cloud Cell. We go over here and click on that. Cloud Cell is a 5 GB persistent home directory, and it's on Debian Linux. Click on continue. Let me open it more. So we have to wait a little bit. Great. As you can see, this is the project ID that I have here. And my account is a student account. It's always a good tip to check which is your active account. So copy and paste this command. For you at home, don't copy and paste. Try to type it down, because that's how you are going to learn. Authorize. And my active account is the student account I have from Qwik Labs. That's great. And now I want to check the list project ID over here. Again, don't copy and paste, just type gcloud config list project. And we can see that the project is this one. Great, everything is fine. Now we want to ensure that the project has the correct permissions. So we go to imadmin, im. And over here, compute engine and editor, everything is fine. So we don't have to do anything else. But if you don't see it over here, then you have to follow the next steps. Go to IAM admin IAM, the page that we are here. Click on add over here. You click add. You need to insert the new member. Over here, you take your project number. Only this you have to change, and the rest is fine. And on the roles, you have to go to project and then to editor. And then click save, but not for us. I have it already over here. Now we're going to create a Cloud BigQuery dataset and table using Cloud Shell. Okay, for this lab, we have the option to use either Cloud Shell or the user interface of Google Cloud platform. I prefer to go for this video with the Cloud Shell. So I'm going to write BQ. BQ is for BigQuery. I want to make taxi rides, or it's easier for me because I have done it so many times, and hit enter. What it does, it created a dataset on the BigQuery. We will go there later. And now I'm going to check my progress. Everything is fine. So over here, 25 out of 100. Now I'm going to create a table, and over here we say BigQuery make a time partition field times tab, where the schema is going to have all these details, and the table is going to be taxi rides real time. So it's the real time taxi rides are the dataset. We can copy it and paste it, and then hit enter. The output must be table blah 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 something successfully created. Again, it is successfully created. Check my progress, and it's fine. So now we have to create a storage bucket. So over here we are going to create the bucket, but we have to delete this one. For storage bucket, as I told you already in a previous video, we have to use a unique name. So unique name is Qwik Labs from outer space dash 123 is completely different from Qwik Labs from outer space. So for me over here, what I do is always get the idea of my project, because it is unique. It is created just for us, just for my student account. Your student account has a completely different project ID, so it's unique. That's how I'm going over here, and I want to export my bucket name. It is exported. Now I want to check if everything is okay. And now I'm creating a bucket, and it is created. So I'm gonna check my progress. Everything is fine. And now we will go to run the pipeline section. Instead of doing what we have done here with the Cloud Shell, we could do it with the Cloud Console. So we could go over here to navigation menu and scroll down to BigQuery is over here. Done. I have already created things, as you can see, taxi rides and real time. What you could do is from here, click on where is it? Create dataset, and insert taxi rides over here. Default, never. Click on create. Then you could check your progress, and you could do all these steps, but we have already done them, and create the bucket. And now we are here, we're coding from here. So to run the pipeline, we have to go to the navigation menu, go to Dataflow, over here. We need to, okay, let's close the panel. We need to create a job from a tablet. And we are going to enter a job for our cloud. Okay, let's say testing data flow. Under the default tablet, we have to expand it and find PubSub to BigQuery. Topic, not subscription. Close again the panel. We have to copy this and enter it here. Under the BigQuery output table, we have to put this, but also change my project with the name that we have specified. You remember here, the bucket, the project. And temporary location. Your bucket name. My bucket name is this one. If everything is fine and we run the job, here is the pipeline. We have infos. We have one warning log. The workflow name is not valid. We have job metrics over here that you can check. It needs some minutes to work. Let's check my progress. Everything is fine, 100%. And you can watch your source build and become ready for use. When everything is ready, it will stop working. Now it's still working. And then we can go to BigQuery and submit a query. So we have to wait a little bit. Okay, let's go to BigQuery. Why not? Over here. Our project, our data set, our table. And what we want is to run a query, so let's copy it and paste it over here. This is the query editor. If you don't want to have everything in one line, we can go more, format, so select all from my project ID, taxi riders, real time limit 100, and I have to replace my project ID. So now it's perfect, that's why I have a green check over here. And if I run it, I have results over here and in JSON format from real time. The details. Okay, this is just perfect because we did so many things in so little time. We have pulled 1,000 taxi rides from a PubSub topic and pushed them to BigQuery table. As you saw firsthand, tablets are particularly easy to use when to run Dataflow jobs, and be sure to check out more on Google Cloud tablets over here. as usual for your next steps, but first, okay, let's come over here. Oh, and we have a test, test your understanding. I'm not going to do it for you. Please try it by yourselves. It's very easy. Google Cloud Dataflow supports batch processing. It's true or false? Don't worry, you have finished the lab. Even if you answer false, wrong, the question over here or this question, the lab is already accepted and you will get a green check because you have got all the score here, 100 out of 100. And you are going to get a step closer to your badge to get it. So let me stop the lab. I can close it from here. Don't do it on your real project because everything is working and you are going to get charged. But here I'm on my student account, which was created just for me, just for this lab. So I can close it directly from here. And let's expand it. Next steps. We have worked with Dataflow. It's really important to understand that Dataflow is a great tool for engineering. And if you come over here, you can on cloud.google.com/dataflow, you can read more about it, what it can do, the documentation. If you scroll down, there are quick start tutorials and use cases with stream analytics, because Dataflow can do both stream and batch. We have real time. Everything is written here. It's a good tip always after each lab to go and check the documentation of the tool, of the technology that you have already used. So thank you for watching this video. See you on the next one.